So this evening there's a couple of scratch performances, which means that people are testing things out on the audience, the willing guinea pigs out there. So we'll be doing a little bit of campery and buffoonery beforehand. Then you'll get a real piece of artwork. We'll come on, do some more campery and buffoonery, and you'll get some more real artwork.
Like to know what's going on in my mind. So let me get right to the point. I don't pop my cork for every guy I see. Hey, meat spender! Hey, meat spender!
My name's the Kommander, and I am doing two pieces tonight, which I've put together. The first one is called The Sin Eater, which is around, based on an old pagan and Christian myth, whereby the family of the recently dead would employ a sin eater to eat bread and ale over the body to take their sins from them. And that's applied to how gay men treat each other. And the second piece is called The Bull, and it's looking at the current views of the church, of the Catholic Church, and their views on women and homosexuality and trans people, but also reflecting back their historical, some of the historical events that have happened, which show the contradictions between their perspectives.
Pope Joan reigned as Pope for a number of years during the Middle Ages. A learned and talented woman, Joan joined the church disguised as a man during a time when women were deemed incapable of understanding the scriptures. Her true sex was revealed when she gave birth during the procession. She died after being tied to the back of
the... I've been working on it for a while, and this was the kind of the right opportunity to do that. And also I'm really looking forward to working with the team. The tech team are really good, all the organisers are really good, they're really helpful, and they've kind of made it come to life and made it work in a way that beyond what I kind of originally envisaged. And they're also going to help me kind of navigate around, because all of my costumes are quite restrictive. This is the Sin Eater, so it's like he's been essentially he's been in the woods for years and years. Well, millennia really, and he's out because he senses that there's lots of immoral actions going on, and so he feeds on the sins of others. So that's one of them. It's a little bit wobbly.
So I'm Shell Byron, and I do a comedy character, stand-up comedy of she's called Ally Allerton, and she's sort of an alter ego of mine. She's based very much on me, but also a little bit on my cat. I used to joke about doing a voice that I thought my cat would have if she spoke, and that's sort of where the voice and things came from.
But I can help you. Like I say, I'm here for you. I'm here to help you. And I can teach you people skills that you're just so sorely lacking. I mean, look at this conversation I'm doing all the way.
I've been gigging for a while now, for just a year, if you could count it as that. I took kind of a big break off. So really just since January. I do small gigs in different clubs that do stand up, like I do the Slaughterhouse when they have Laughter Factor on. I've done Hot Water. I won my first heat of a Hot Water New Comedian of the Year, and I went through to the final and I got runner up in that, and I was in the final of Echo Comedian of the Year as well.
See, now I'm going to make a connection with him.
Who are you?
Chris. So I'm going to make a meaningful connection with Chris now. First thing that's important to know is that we need to make eye contact. Chris is now at ease. Because he knows that I'm attentive and listening and that I care about what he's got to say.